Today I'm really excited to introduce our newest Joggles products, Watercolor Art Parts and Sentiments. Laser cut from Strathmore's 140-pound watercolor paper, these shapes and words are the jumping-off point for art journal pages, cards, mixed-media projects, and much more. With our Art Parts and Sentiments, the fiddly bits have been done, leaving you ready to create in an instant. No machines, platform shims, or any of that stuff. Simply snip the tab to remove the piece and get creating. Like our accordion books and our disc-bound journals, Watercolor Art Parts and Sentiments are made from Strathmore's 140-pound cold-pressed watercolor paper. That means you have a nice, sturdy piece that you can work with that's going to stand up to all kinds of wet or dry media. There's lots of different ways that you can use these. I'm going to demo some paints and some sprays, just the barest beginning to get you started. But the first thing you have to do before you do anything is you have to snip the shape out of the background piece. So this is an 8.5 by 11 piece of paper, and it will have some number of elements on it depending on the size and what the actual shape is. They're all put together the same way, or they're all cut the same way. We've left little tabs in here that hold the piece in place so that all you have to do is trim them off. So you just reach in with some scissors, and this is 140-pound watercolor paper, so don't think you're going to tear this. You really do need to snip it to remove the pieces. Most of them just have a few, just enough to keep them, just enough to keep them in place so that we can get them packaged and they're not flopping all over the place, and you know, they stay nice and neat and in really good shape for you. So once you get the piece out, what you're left needing to do, the tabs are going to require, you can't cut them neatly when you take them out, so the tabs are going to require that you come back and just trim it into the shape of the piece. You can see that this one is on a curve on the edge of the bird here, so I want to trim that. There's another one over here. I'm going to do the same thing. There's one on the tail. I'll trim that off. And then the one that was between his little legs here actually came off pretty well, so there's not any trimming needing to be done right there. Now, what I will show you later, this left, these are not your typical stencils, but you can certainly use them like that. I can separate these out, lay them down on a background, mask off everything I don't want, and then just spritz through them. Now, they're paper, so they're only going to last, you know, an indefinite period of time. You won't have them ad infinitum, but it's certainly another way to use what's left. And then when it comes time to work with your pieces, and as I said, I'll show you all of this. So here are some of the smaller birds from that sheet. And then there's a variety of ways that you can add color and pattern to these. You can add sprays. I'll show you how I use watercolor paint to paint them. That's what this bird was done with. This was done with, I think, dilutions, ink sprays, and distress spray stains in water brushes. You can stencil on them after the fact. You can doodle on them after the fact. The sky's the limit. So let's get started on all of those fun ways to embellish these pieces. I have out Zig watercolors. You can use the Prima ones, you can use your fine art brands, you can use whatever it is that you have. And I'm going to paint kind of in a coloring style. I'm not going to do a whole lot of blending. I just want to lay color on, and trust me, you can do this. This is not difficult at all. So this is one of the Pentel. This is the large size on their water brushes. I'm going to grab, well, this is not a super clean piece of paper towel, but I'm going to work with this piece of paper towel. And I want to make certain that, though that's stained, there's no color in there. So what I'm going to do is, I've got purple, kind of a magenta color, and a turquoise, and I've got a little bit of black. So I think I'm going to put kind of a grayed down line in the center. So I'm going to start with a little bit of black, and then I'm going to grab some of the, I think some of the turquoise. So I've grayed this down, and now what I'm going to do is put a fair amount of water in there so that I can water it down. And if I want to check the, I can use the back just to see what this color looks like. And that's a little bit darker than what I want, so I'm going to, again, squeeze the reservoir on the water brush and squeeze out some more water. And now I can see that I'm closer to where I want to be. I've penciled some lines in here. I hope that you can see them. You might not be able to, but trust me, they're there. All I want to do is kind of put this vein in. I'm going to put that right down through that spine on the stem, all the way down. Now I'm going to quickly hit this with some heat, just enough to dry it. If I come back with watercolor where this is already wet, it's going to bleed into each other, and I want the water to kind of stay where it is. I want to leave the pattern the way that it is. So I'm not doing a fantastic job here, but you're going to get the idea of one of the ways that you can do this. So that looks like it's close enough. It's not super wet, so it doesn't really take long. So I've kind of segmented this off. I've got a piece here, a piece here, a piece here, and then the bottom. And I'll probably just mimic that on the other side. So again, taking my only partly clean piece of paper towel. Now I'm gonna grab some of the pink, and you can see that this is in pieces. That's because I dropped the whole box of them, which was just big fun. And I might gray this down, I've lost track, that's black. I might gray this down just the tiniest bit by picking up some of the black. And I'm actually gonna turn this toward me. I'm gonna lay that color in here. And you can see how easily this goes on. And then I think I'm gonna put some up at the top here. Now again, I'll want to dry this before it's time to put anything next to it, so I'll just come in. There are ways to do this that's easier, but for the purposes of being able to show you the entire process, it does take me a minute to kind of dry. There's other ways that I could do this if I were working just for myself, but as I said, for demonstration purposes, this will be okay. So I'm going to clean that color out. Now I'm going to grab some of the turquoise, but I want to grab some of the original color that is not, let's come back here, that is not grayed out, and I'm going to put that in here. One of the things that I can do that will help me differentiate these areas is I'll come back with a pit pen, and I can put some lines on here, and you can see that not only did I do that here, I also added some dots to sections. It's just a real easy way to kind of get this done. Now I think I'm going to grab a little bit of the purple, and I'm going to blend these colors together. Let's pick up some more of that, and now I'm really going to need to hit my paper towel. So I've got kind of a dull purple. I don't want this too dark. Again, I'm going for kind of pastel look here, and I'm going to do most of this side, that color. In fact, I think I'm going to do, well, that wasn't very neat. I'm going to do all of the side this color. Again, I'm not doing a really good job. You'll take a little bit more time and be a little bit neater than I'm being. I can actually correct some of that. Well, that's a mess. I can correct some of that when I come in and I hit it with the pit pen. So now I'm just going to pick up some straight purple. Oh, that's the turquoise, not what I wanted to do. Let's grab the purple, which is over here, and I'm just going to squeeze the reservoir to feed some water down through to the bristles. There we go. All right, I don't think that's too dark. Maybe I'll add just a little bit of pink to this, so I change that color a little bit, and it doesn't look like any of the other ones that are on there. All right, I think that's good enough. So I'm just going to come in and very poorly, again, lay the watercolor down here. All right, so I'm going to take my finger mark out of there. What I'm going to do now is push all this out of the way. I'm going to dry while I kind of clean up my mess, and then I'll grab, for something really delicate like this, I like to use the extra super fine pit pens. That's the one that's marked XS like this. I find that it allows me to get a very light, sketchy line if that's what I want to accomplish. Again, this is not the nicest feather. This is by far a better example, but I never claim to be a fine artist. All right, so let's just kind of uncurl this. And now I'm not going to talk, because if I talk, I'm really going to make a mess. So what I'm doing is establishing the boundaries of the color with the pen, even though I kind of overlapped when I put the color on. One of the interesting things that you can do here is you can doodle on these, which I think is really fun. So for example, if I want to put some circles in this segment right here, I can certainly do that. If I want to come back, someplace here I have jelly roll pens. If I want to come back with a jelly roll pen, let's grab this color, and I want to fill these dots in just to make it look a little bit more interesting. And I'm careful, I'm trying not to cover the black line that I put on there, so I'm just putting a little dot of color in the center. But you can see how this starts to get more and more interesting as you begin to add all of these little details. If I want to come in, for example, and I just want to add some dots along here like this, sometimes it's just simple little things like that that take things from being kind of interesting to really, really interesting. Now I want to show you how to add color and pattern using your spray inks. And I'm talking Distress, I'm talking Dilutions, I'm talking Lindy's, I'm talking about Marabu's Fashion Spray because it works on all porous surfaces, and Fashion Shimmer, the same thing. I'm looking at Art Spray, all of those kinds of things you can use on your watercolor art parts and your watercolor sentiments. So this is the feather I finished in the last segment, or I colored in the last segment, and you can see it looks way better. Let's admit it was pretty crappy looking in that last segment, but the addition of line work and the addition of some doodles kind of tightened everything up. It no longer looks to be such a mishmash of color. Now it actually looks like a feather. So I used liquid pearls. You can't feel them, but I can. There's little tiny dots here. I'm going to show you using stickles. I mean, all the kinds of things that you're used to doing, you're going to do on watercolor art parts and watercolor sentiments. So let's bring in three birds, and I'm going to show you an example of that. So these are three birds. These are the smaller ones from the sheet, and I lined them up and I sprayed them, and then I came back once that was dry, and this is our branches stencil. It's one of the 9x12. All I did was put them next to one another. You can tape them to the table if you want. And then I just added some, this is one of the Sparks colors from the Finnebert Art Alchemy line. I think it's Ginger Magic. All I did was put that through the openings of the stencil, and then I came back again with an extra super fine pit pen, and I outlined those elements to make them look pretty interesting. So I'm going to pick three colors. Let's grab, what do we got here? This is the new Dilutions colors, and I think I'm going to bring in a Distressed spray stain. So I'm going to kind of go with warm colors here. Since I want these to look like they belong together, I'm going to spray them kind of as a unit so that they have that look like they belong together. That's probably enough of that. And then let's see, you know what? There's not enough difference in color, so let's go back and let's grab. This is the peony blush. So I'm just going to add a little bit there and a little bit there. At a glance, these certainly look like they belong together, which they do because they were all sprayed together. So you get that kind of continuity among your elements, and when you put them together on the same page, you get that continuity and everything looks like it goes together. Now, there might be times when you don't want that, and that, of course, is an entirely different kettle of fish. And you deal with that however you deal with it, then you can spray them separately if you want. So I could come along and I could lay a stencil over the top and I could spray on those, or I could come back instead with some Lindy's. And what I did here was I deliberately let the Lindy's spit and make some large dots. Now this is the ink spray, that's from the original color, but this was a lighter color of a Starburst spray, so I'm just going to grab a different one. And rather than mist to get a layer of color, I'm going to let this thing spit so I end up with more dots like that. Now obviously I'm not going to dry this, but this will dry and it'll have the magical shimmer, all that wonderful look that you get from the Lindy's. But I'm also going to have parts that I can come back, elements that I can use, that I can doodle on, which makes this so much more interesting. So now let me bring in something else. So this is the watercolor sentiments. This is Happy Birthday. Obviously this has been clipped. You can see the one that I used right here. Now this is a card. These are some of the leaf fronds in the background. It's very simple, but I think it's very effective. You don't have to go over the top. You don't have to go completely crazy to make a really nice, attractive card. So on the watercolor sentiments, all I did was what you just see me do, which with the birds, was I laid these, the two words down, it spritzed them, then I came back with a Lindy's and I let that kind of blotchy thing happen. And I think that this works. It can be very effective that way. So here is another card. So this one was done completely differently. This is loose. I'm going to show you this in 1 second. These are the wildflowers. I forget which ones. This is number one. I don't remember what this is. And I used a similar technique that I used to do this feather. I did here to color the stems and the wildflowers themselves. And again, there's a lot of pen work in there that makes a big difference. It takes something, well, I don't have one that's colored but not actually had the pen work on it, but it takes something that's bland, even though there's color on it, and by adding the pen work, I add the detail and it makes it really interesting. I also added some stickles on here because you can see them, because why not? It makes it look great. So on this particular watercolor sentiment, on the thank you, I took one of the shimmer colors from the Zig watercolors. I want to say that this is called silver, although to me it's really kind of a pearl color. And you can see that I've got on the back here, these are the little the word is not going to come out of my mouth. These are the little dimensional adhesive sticky things. These are little tiny ones. This is made by Scrapbook Adhesives. I can't think of the name of them. And of course, I can't put my hands on them, though they were here 5 seconds ago. I swear to God, they just get up and they walk away from my table. But you can see when you've got little elements like the letters, these are the quarter inch by quarter inch ones. Snip them in half, you get little tiny pieces. You get enough on the back there, and I think that this is much more effective. So you can see how that would look if it was just laying flat on the surface. But I think it's much more effective, like the word thank is, when it's raised up. It gives you a much nicer look. The last thing I want to show you today is how to take your leftover backgrounds when you've removed all of the watercolor art parts and how to use what's left as a stencil. So this is this piece underneath here where those four small birds were. And I can do the same thing with each of these other sections if I want to use them like a stencil to make the larger birds. So all I've done is masked this off. I've put this down over a piece of watercolor paper and I've masked it off so I keep the spray confined to the area where the birds are. And this time I'm gonna use some cool colors. I've got some greens, so I'm just gonna kinda use them just to get some color on here. And then I've got a Lindy's because, well, because I can, honestly. That's why I would do anything with Lindy's, because I love the color. So ultimately this will dry and I'll get some nice shimmer. Let's just see if I can take the masking off here, lift this all up. And there you go. So you kind of get the effect of what's going on. Now, if I want to strengthen the shape of the birds, I could outline them. Actually, you know what? Before I make a mess, let's wipe this up. I could outline them with a pit pen to really, as I said, to strengthen those shapes. You can see that I missed right there. I didn't do as good a job masking as I should have. You'll do a better one. But once I get these outlined, then I can start to doodle on them the way that I do any of the others. So these are the ones that I sprayed a few minutes ago. Let's kind of slide this out of the way. And you can see this time I actually used a super fine, so the S-tip pit pen, which gives me a little bit heavier lines. But with all of these things, you do them, you treat them all like you do all of the other things that you work on. You have your own technique and your own style. You doodle in your own fashion. And so you have these pieces that become very much your own once you add your own personality and flavor to them. So to come back for a second to the thing that I mentioned a moment ago in the last segment, and you can see that I've gone ahead and I've got the word you on this card. These are Scrapbook Adhesive 3D foam squares. This is the thing I couldn't think of the name of and I couldn't put my hands on a moment ago. But what I do, these are quarter by a quarter. You can cut these into smaller pieces, get them on the really delicate parts of the watercolor sentiments if you want that raised look. So watercolor art parts, watercolor sentiments, I think you're going to find lots of ways to use these. I know I'm going to find lots of ways to use them in my art journals, on my cards, on all of those fun things.